Hello everyone, it's Trafalgar Valentine. How's things going today? Today I've been doing something a little bit more different than usual. Been thinking, what can I do different? What have other people done and stuff? And I like to do heavily modified vehicles, something that no one's ever seen before. So to conclude such expectations, here's going to be a Plymouth Barracuda ice cream tank. What is Barracuda Plymouth ice cream tank, you say? Well, this is going to be the car modified into an ice cream truck, heavily modified with a souped up engine, ice cream decals, modified also for warfare with machines, guns and stuff like that, and also heavily tracks for the tank kind of part. I'll do this in different sections just because it's quite a big complex picture, but we'll see how it goes. To start off with the Plymouth Barracuda shape, just doing a thin front vent for the front, and this is where it comes up. Looking at the reference photo, the bonnet curls up just at the window there. Now for the engine, you're not going to see much of it because it's quite a high top vehicle. When it's higher up, the engine will be higher and higher up, but it's going to have two exhaust stacks coming out the top, which is flared. So, and in here is going to be the engine, where it's going to have a blower. This part of the body curls up, then for the window, and here's the side window, so it just comes up and down here. Now I'm going to do a modified next window across here for the ice cream customer panel, ice cream customer panel. Maybe that's a good idea. You'll see what I mean when I shade it all in and stuff. Do the side part with the wheel arches coming up, like so. Now for the, maybe just do the front bumper. Some lights will come here, and it's got this curved vent which comes down here. Okay, it's looking good. The exhaust stacks are pretty ridiculous, but I like that. I like ridiculous. This is going to be an ice cream sign on top. Then I'm going to do a massive ice cream cone on top of here. Okay. It's looking nice. Two small details in the front. I'm just doing this a rough sketch and pencil, then I'll probably rub out a lot of these lines just to give me reference for where things to go. Don't know how big those lights are, that maybe they're too big, but we'll see. Okay, so the front bit has three small square chunks either side of it, coming into a V shape into the middle. So I've chopped these lights down a bit here. Okay, I think that's good for the main body. Maybe start with the guns at the bottom. So first gun to turn around, I'm just gonna do a disc basically shape that hangs underneath it so the gun can rotate here. So there's gonna be one underneath. Sort of like when the helicopters have one on front. It's going to be quite a heavy barrage gun, so it's going to have quite a large bullet. So I'm doing some large stacks. And these are just basically cylinder shapes with a circle in the center to give the edge around. Sat on top of a cube. So it's pretty straightforward, the shapes. And this will be the ammo belt that comes down from the arch. So the ammo boxes will be in here. That'll feed the machine gun at the bottom. Okay, here, maybe do a sideways one. It's gonna be like a step on the side so people can actually access the display panel and stuff, so people want actually ice cream on it there. Then this will also be likewise to the front. I'm doing similar guns, apart from where these two are blocked together either side. This one's gonna be two blocked vertically. Thinking what colours I could do, I probably might do this red, then the gun's probably purple, then maybe the tracks at the bottom blue maybe. Trying to keep some of these lines parallel. Okay, it's starting to take a nice shape. We'll just see if there's any of this probably won't stick out on the other side, so it's okay. Right, I think that's ready to start decorating the body and stuff. Now I've got the main shapes down. Right, where to start? Should I start off with the red pencil? Just to some parts of the areas and stuff. I'm just rubbing this line out just because I don't want the grey to underneath it, and you'll see why. Okay, and then go for this side. This bonnet slightly curls up at the yet. Maybe a third of the way across, so you can see that how goes up. This will be straight across there, but curl it up there. Now I'm thinking I might actually do these exhaust stack stuff with, just because they're right in the way of everything. So my light source is probably going to be coming from this direction, so everything on this side is going to be lighter. Okay, so I'm going to do a maybe a yellow tone. Yellow tone would be nice. Just on this side. Ruler. Okay. Oh, this would be so awesome if this was going through the street right now. You should probably set off for work or something like that, or maybe having a bad day and all of a sudden coming across the street. Plymouth Barracuda ice cream tank. Because this is chrome, there's not going to be that much variation in the shapes of it and stuff. So it's just going to be straight stacks basically. Try and keep them both equal at the same time as well. Going with a dark fine line pen just to isolate that a bit more. Yeah, it's looking nice. Okay, that's looking nice. So now that the next exhaust stacks to extend, I'll probably go in them to do a few more details and stuff. Let's carry on with the front bonnet shape. It's a nice clean crisp line going across there. It's going to have the main bonnet opens up around here, so it's going to be a thick edge. Follow that round, and same on the other side. Okay, so that's most of the front end done. Now I'm going to do the front grill. Which pen should I use? Maybe a 0.3. That'll be too dark. I mean, too. No, I think that should be okay. Second thought. What's this? Does this one even say how big it is? It doesn't. Whatever nib this is certainly small enough anyway for what I would like to do. It's good. Okay, so the front curls at the sides. So I'll keep the line here to where the bonnet joins it up. Smooth. Okay. Do a line across. Okay, that's good. Now for the lights. Might do these actually in grey. So the bonnet itself, I used a few fine liners here, just to some of the edges, leave some white highlights on the top. One over is some oranges as well, just to even it out. Might even just go over a few of them in actually yellow. Just a little bit. Okay. Okay, back to here. This is where the main highlights have come. So where I've drawn this second one, it comes to just about this line here on the bonnet. So for this side, we've got there, and there. Curl this bit in. Okay, nice. Now for the lights. A lot when you do the lights, it's just the indication of the surface that you've got to draw with reflected to the environment as well. But the majority of the lights is like crisscrossed and got a few various shapes on it and stuff. So as long as you do a lot of detail on the actual lights to indicate the it's not just a solid light bulb or something, smooth and everything. Should look fine. And I think it'll help as well if I did an even consistency, i.e. that the lights would all be the same. This bit behind them will be that black. Okay, it looks nice. Likewise to this side. So I did a line going across. Oh, here, here, here. Then dot, dot. See what kind of effect this creates. Okay, those lights are looking pretty good. Especially for the size of the picture. This is A4, but it's on a portrait. So it's still probably an A5 size car. So it's still pretty good detail for an A5 car. Do some grey tones around it. Just to break up the. Sometimes when you've got solid lines, it's good to break it up, transition between the white and the black. Because it looks too harsh and it would stand out a lot more. And sometimes you have things that stand out on your car that you won't want to stand out and stuff. So I'm just doing some grey in between that line. And here. And sometimes when you're drawing a custom vehicle like this that you don't know, sometimes, I mean, you can pre-plan everything. Sometimes things will look different, you may have a different idea and stuff. So like when you're painting it and you put paint down and stuff, it's, you always got to like tease certain areas or try some areas. If this works, then this not works. With enough practice, I mean, you can actually adjust pitches quite easily. You can fix different shapes and stuff like that. As long as you've got the end goal in mind and you know exactly where the picture is going, then you have nothing really to worry about. You can modify any mistake you wanted. Okay, it's looking nice. Might do a yellow tone just on this edge bit here. Might even do yellow bits in the lights. Okay, it looks nice. Let's do the middle section. So this is just what I meant by teasing, basically. I saw when I was doing black here, I just thought, well, I've got the black pen, man, I might just do a few touches up on here, just where some areas where it's the most darkest, just to bring it out that little bit. Just gotta be careful not to do too much, though. Okay, back to the grill bit. So I'll smooth out some of these black lines here that I've just done. I think it's looking along nicely though. I've teased some few of the black pieces here and there. I'm still learning how to actually draw car reflections properly and stuff like that. I'm still in the learning process. I'm not a professional or anything. I'm just a guy who loves doing this. This is spare time. But I've got to hurry along, but I've got to work soon. Okay, so I'm using a biro pen just because I can use different gradations depending on how hard I actually press it. Just to actually break up some of the lighter tones and grey tones and stuff. I might do the front scoop in the middle here. So curls up at the sides. Didn't stick out that much just because it's not that high. Comes around there, down. So yeah, I've just gone over the hood and basically with the doing the red inlet circles here that scoops in the air basically. And on the top I've just gone still like the yellow kind of haze. I want the yellow haze on to give it some warm tone. So I'm just maintaining that across here. Nice and pretty. Across there. Okay, now the front's looking nice. Let's just zoom out to see what it looks like. Yeah, it's looking good. Right. Now I'm just gonna do the bottom part of the bumper here. I might clean up some of these lines first. Okay, this bit's pretty straightforward. It's just like another bottom section that sticks out. Again, we'll curl this up. So just this part of the front grill actually just sticks out. You can see that. If I didn't want this part of the grill, I could curl this up to the top, like on the modern supercars and stuff, but not for this one. It curls up there. Darkest tone's gonna be at the bottom of the grill. So what I'll do is I'm going to do a highlight in the center. So from this line, it's going to be a sort of lighter tone. And from the top, then to emphasize the shape curling around, following that highlight curling up there, as you can see. Going with another darker red tone with a fine pen just at the bottom. Okay, that's looking nice. Maybe just slight grey, darker tone there. Fill this line in. I want this bottom line to be quite dark as well. Curl up. Okay, that's looking nice. Maybe just an orange tone just to break it up a little bit. Go back in with the yellow. Okay, it's looking good. So it's just about these layers that I'm creating. I've done the red pencil, the highlight in the center, and I've gone on the red pen just to outline the edges, leaving some bits not in red pen, like there. Bit of orange, bit of yellow on top. There we are. Right, what's next? We'll do continue the bumper going down, I think. I've got a photo reference, so I know where I'm going. But these lines were just, they're kind of there to give the overall perspective. I mean, if you, once you have all the pencil lines down, you can modify it and stuff like that to make sure that everything has that even consistency. You can draw a car just by starting off by doing this, but you're not quite sure how this would look with the back or anything like that. You sort of have to kind of make it up as you go along, which is, yeah, you can do that, but because I'm drawing a very precise vehicle, i.e. Plymouth Barracuda ice cream tank, I want things to be of an even consistency. I mean, someday I'll probably do a picture where it won't be such even consistency, but for this one there is. Okay, so I have two lights, just slightly slanted downwards. It's going to be a darker red going down here, just because this is not reflecting the yellow on top. So where the light comes around. You know, I've just done a red red marker just to give me some more, just to block in some more light, shall we say. I'm going to do some of the darker bits in purple. It's not quite black, but it's looking quite dark. I might pick another purple. But I'm just going to keep the consistency, so I'm just going to finish up a few bits here and there. Okay, now it's on the bottom section. The bottom section, I did those multiple layers of red, oranges, purples, blacks, greys, and over the top of all the pencil layers, I put another grey marker just to darken this whole section off. I wanted this bit to be a lot more darker than the actual top itself. So I'll probably do some white highlights, like some dots here and there, but I'll do that afterwards. Might use this as well, what I've got in my hand. I've got two actually, I'm not sure which one's lighter. This one's probably lighter. Use it in some other places. Okay. And with the wheel arch coming up here, I want the horizon line to come round about there. I wonder if it'd be too much if I just did a red pen going across there. That should be okay. Just see another detail I nearly missed out. The light just here. Before I go, I might start just doing some of the decals on the sides, so I might do this in light blue. Just around the edges. Well, keep the horizon line as well, so I might go from there. So the horizon line's following across the car. This red pen just might actually emphasize the horizon line across the whole car now. Ooh, just noticed the time. Right, I'm gonna have to go jump to work now. But anyway, this is the first hour of the first front end. It's coming along nicely, as you can see. I'm zooming right out now. So yeah, this is going to be the front. Next time we'll consistency just keep on going with the bodywork and with the guns at the bottom and then the tracks at the bottom. Okay, thanks very much for watching, and I'll be back with this real soon.